If you are a frequent browser of the Fusion subreddit, or any subreddit of a parametric 3D modeler for that matter, you will notice a theme to the problems raised. It can be summarized as the inability to recognize the underlying basic shape. I've made a few videos in the past talking about 3D modeling workflows, and this is always the first step. It is also the hardest step. I recently came across a problem in the SolidWorks subreddit that perfectly illustrates the importance of recognizing the underlying basic shapes involved in the model before doing anything. When I first looked at this model, it was readily apparent that the most challenging part will be to create these faces. Take note that these faces are actually not flat. If you look from the bottom, there is actually a slight curvature to these faces. My instinct was to create each of these faces one by one. First, I will create these two faces and somehow loft or sweep the faces on the side. I quickly went down a rabbit hole and spent a lot of time, but I just could not quite get the look. Then I realized that I had failed to practice what I had been preaching. I had failed to ask the simple question, is there a basic underlying shape? It turns out that there is. If you look at the front face, it is actually one single continuous face in the shape of an arc. After creating the main solid, we can simply trim it on the front and the back with an arc. So we need to imagine a point before these faces have been cut in. The main shape will look something like this. Let's start off with this sketch. These two arcs would take care of the slight curvature. Begin and extrude with this sketch. This will serve as our base. Let's take a look at the final model again. Ignore these fillers for the moment and focus on this face. Try to extrapolate this face to the point before these faces were cut in. It is simply an offset of the base. I have prepared a second sketch here. Extrude this, making sure to join to the base. Add in the fillets. Now it is just a matter of trimming the front and the back. We will be using this sketch. Begin an extruded cut. Set the extent to all. Mirror this cut about the front plane. So these complicated looking faces are simply a result of how the extrudes interact with each other. This really emphasizes the importance of recognizing the basic shapes involved. I also want to point out that I did not manage to do this on my first try. I went through quite a few iterations. I started out with a cylinder and realized that it did not quite produce a shape needed before I landed on the final shape. It is always important to at least try your best to create a shape as close as possible. There is no such thing as a wasted attempt. Every failed attempt informs you of the next step to take. Another way to do this would be to create a solid in this shape and cut on the left and right side. I will leave that to you to try.